The SPAC market continues to gain momentum. Private equity and hedge fund managers, esteemed business professionals, and even celebrities have participated in SPACs as both investors and sponsors. Some notable companies to go public via SPAC deals include sports betting firm DraftKings and space tourism company Virgin Galactic. There have been $166 billion in SPAC-led deals in 2021 alone, while in 2020, SPACs raised a record $73 billion. But what exactly is a SPAC? A Special Purpose Acquisition Company, or SPAC, is a public shell company formed by sponsors, typically private equity and hedge fund managers, who have a strong background in a particular industry or business sector. SPACs are created solely to raise money through an IPO to buy another private company, effectively taking them public. Funds raised by the sponsors are kept in an interest-bearing account for up to 2 years, while investors wait for the sponsors to acquire a private company. Once the SPAC finds its target, they merge, and the private company gains a spot in the public exchange quickly, avoiding the traditional IPO process. How do SPACs differ from traditional IPOs? The SEC requires companies filing through a traditional IPO to provide in-depth paperwork that can take 6 to 9 months or even longer before shares are offered to the public. A SPAC IPO requires much less paperwork and can take just a few months to complete. Once a SPAC announces its target, both the sponsor and the target company can make certain projections to investors, which is not generally allowed in the traditional IPO process. While this may pose some risks to investors, it may also boost the SPAC's share price in the short term before the regulatory documents associated with the merger are publicly released. Here's how the trade typically works for early investors, like a hedge fund. SPACs have three common stages with unique risk-reward characteristics, making them an attractive place for some investors to park their cash. Hedge funds start by investing in a SPAC IPO, receiving both shares and warrants. Warrants give the hedge fund the right to buy more shares of the company at a predefined price. The second stage occurs after the merger is announced. The shares will react based on how investors perceive the deal. If a deal is perceived unfavorably and the shares decrease in value, the hedge fund has the right to redeem their shares for cash, providing some downside protection in the case of a loss. The third stage occurs after the merger is completed. The shares will rise and fall based on the new company's outlook, just like any other stock. If the SPAC shares rise, there can be potential returns even for hedge funds who sold their shares due to the warrants they received in the IPO. A SPAC is only as good as its sponsor. The SPAC sponsor is responsible for identifying a private company with a strong management team or entrepreneur where there is a potential for a profitable deal. Investing in sponsors that have successful track records at deal making is key. Sign up to learn which institutional private equity and hedge fund managers on our platform invest in and/or sponsor SPACs.